Welcome, everybody, to the Lake Placid 2023 FISU World University Games. We're here in Mount Van Hovenberg for the biathlon competition. This is the men's 12K pursuit, which will be followed by the women's 10K pursuit. Now, if you were watching yesterday, it's a similar format to the cross-country pursuits that we had yesterday, a little bit longer than the 5 and 10K pursuits, but you will start, and we will start the men's 12K pursuit with the times from yesterday's competition. So the men's 10K sprint yesterday will determine the start order and the start times for the pursuit today. And it is just what it says on the tin, really. It's a pursuit. Number one will go first, and we'll start with a 8-second lead over Bjorn Vesterveldt, who was in silver medal. Let's have a look at how it all went down yesterday. Alexandra Mukin from Kazakhstan going across in the bronze medal position. There is the American, Bjorn Vesterveldt. Able to cross the line in silver, and from Kazakhstan, to Lubakov wins the gold and crosses with an 8-second lead over the American. And there is Benkente to Lubakov. So we'll see the time differences on the right of your screen. Now, anyone really in that top eight has a really good chance, because we're visiting the range four times today with this 12.5 kilometer pursuit, and expect the lead to change around. Even Thibaut Frechard of France there will have a chance if they shoot well. Alex Garnier of France also could do well. Cale Woods from the United States, and there are 37 skiers in the competition. There is the silver medalist, Bjorn Vesterveldt from the United States, and the temperature just a little bit colder than yesterday, and the track has frozen slightly harder than it was. So we're moments away from the start, and you can see the waves and their time differences. There's a big chunk. Here we go, we're off, and we're running with the Kazakhstani Bekente to Lubakov, and starting chasing him down immediately is Bjorn Vesterveldt from the USA. Now we'll have a 20-second gap before we go. 22 seconds, and off and running is Alexandra Mukin from Kazakhstan. Now, if you think that a penalty loop will take around about 20 seconds, give or take, it gives you an idea how important the shoot is, as Kirill Bauer will start, and they go thick and fast here. It's Bauer, Corrales from Kazakhstan, Wojciech Filip from Poland with bib number 6, and then Dmitry Hurushak from Ukraine. So that is your top 9 that are out and on the track. As we look to the leading skier, so this is a 2.5 kilometer track that they will take on 5 times. You can see that's the little group there of the two Kazakhstanis, the Pole, two Poles, and a Ukrainian. So the course length, 2.5 kilometers. The maximum climb is 41 meters. Total climbing is 86 meters. So number one there, Pekente to Lubakov.
Here we go with one or hope for two.
And he's being chased down by Bjorn Vesterveldt. And the gap has been closed. So it was an 8-second gap, but it is much closed up to together as they come in. Now, who's going to be clean? Who will have to ski a penalty loop? Will they both manage to shoot clean here and come out together? Who's going to be the quickest at shooting? Vesterveldt, the quickest into position. And the first shot away from the American, and it's a miss. So Tulubikov shooting from right to left. Vesterveldt shooting in the other direction. Vesterveldt has dropped one, so we'll have to ski that penalty loop. But he shot quickly, and Tulubikov has dropped two. So Vesterveldt goes out in the lead, and we'll ski one penalty loop. And Pekente Tulubikov is going to drop back now. Coming into the range now, if we can watch this chasing group. Whoever shoots clean here will have a real chance of moving up. Won't take the lead because Vesterveldt, with just a one miss, will be in the lead still. But that was a quick shoot there from Yannick of Poland. It's going to be tight. Shot quickly, shot clean. Filip of Hruszczak has all shot clean. So, Vesterveldt is in the lead. Bauer, Kirill Bauer, shot clean, is 17 seconds back. Wojciech Janik of Poland also shot clear, 18 seconds back. Hruszczak of Ukraine, clean, 24 seconds back. And Filip of Poland is clear as well, and 26 seconds back. And Tulubikov, having skied those two penalty loops, has dropped from that leading position into sixth place and is 27 seconds back on the American as they leave the shooting range. Next time they come in, it'll be prone again. It's a smaller target. If you're new to biathlon, the prone targets are the inner circle of the black target that you can see. And it's about the size of a golf ball that they're aiming at when they're in the prone position. Then when they go to standing, they're shooting a target about the size of a CD. If you can remember what CDs are. And this is the chasing group. We've got Kirill Bauer there. Wojciech Janik wearing bib 8. Dmitry Hruszczak wearing 7. Now, 3.9 kilometers split time on this 12.5 kilometer pursuit race. And it was 17 seconds as this group had left the range. They had a deficit of 17 seconds. Now, there is an advantage of skiing together in a group. You do get some slipstreaming, but that time has increased to 20 seconds, or well, 19 seconds. No, actually, no, 17 is where it stood. It's pretty much stayed exactly the same. Janik going through in 17.6, Bauer left the range at 17.1. They are not gaining. A little move there by number 8. the pole. Wojciech Janik moving ahead of the other two. So, can Bjorn Westervelt shoot clear this time around? And if he does, he will maintain that lead. If he drops one, then I think the lead will change. So going through the 4.6 kilometer mark, and it was 17.6 seconds. And Westervelt must have skied that little descent section pretty well, because he skied out 3 seconds over Janik. So ski speed going well for the American. Wax going well. He's carrying speed down the flats, which means he'll glide well across here as well. If he's gliding down the descent, then this is down to how well the waxing is going. Stepping round the corner and last few pushes as we go into the range for the second time. So back into the prone position for the second shoot. Well, Westervelt shot quickly. Shooting time was good, but missed one in the first attempt, the first visit. And missed again. First one, missed again. Ah, the lead has changed, that's for sure. Westervelt needs to be clean on the last, is two penalty loops. He will drop back and he is going to be behind. The question is, which of these three can take the lead away from the American? Janik starts shooting first. He's missed one. Well, of course, if they're not clear, then they're not going to catch the American. Bauer's looking clear. Yannick's dropped two, so his lead will stay the same. Bauer's clear. Bauer's going to do this. Yes, he is. So the Kazakhstani Kirill Bauer has gone clean. Harushak from Ukraine, final shot for him. He's clear as well. Philip of Poland is clear. So those three will be our leaders. Those three will be the leaders as we leave the range. Kirill Bauer going out onto the track, straight out. No penalty loops for him. No penalty loops for the Ukrainian. Harushak and Philip also out on track. 10 seconds back now. Westervelt is out and 17 seconds back now. So three misses in total. Westervelt is skiing around about fourth or fifth with his course times. Yeah, he was fourth on the first loop, second actually on the second loop. So Westervelt's got the ski speed. He just needs to stop missing. Is able to catch up. He's closing back up on Harushchak and Philip, and he's already caught Philip. So Westervelt, one of the quickest skiers. You can see there Westervelt moving ahead of the Pole and the Ukrainian, so definitely got the ski speed. So Bauer is 12 seconds ahead of, or was 12 seconds ahead of Harushak at the 6.4 kilometer split. So what will we see from Bauer, Westervelt, Hrushak and Philipp? They are all coming into the range now. Westervelt is quick, shoots quickly, but needs to be accurate. Bauer will start. Clean so far. A miss from Kirill Bauer. Westervelt. Second from bottom. Two misses from Kirill Bauer. Westervelt misses one. Hrushak is going to go clear. Is he? Yes, he is. So Hrushak should take the lead. Philipp misses one. So Philipp missing one there. I think maybe even missing two. Oh, you can see the American. He's catching. He has the leader in his sights. Bjorn Westervelt is doing this the hard way. Ski speed is so good. Look at the difference in the glide, the speed of the glide, and the relaxed nature and the technique of Westervelt. So it comes down to this. If the Ukrainian is clear and he's shot clean for every single visit to the range, then I think it will be enough to take the gold medal. So seven coming in closest to the camera. This is it. This is the battle for gold and silver. Hrushak, clear. Westervelt, good. They've both been good so far. Oh, Hrushak's dropped one. Westervelt's clean. Hrushak dropping one. Westervelt going clear. Westervelt's going to take the gold medal. And the crowd know it. The crowd are cheering. There's just one lap to go, but it's going to be America in gold medal position. Oh, that is absolutely fantastic for the home fans. It's growing, and we thought it would. So 26 seconds, but even with that, Dmitry Hrushak is safe, I think, in silver. So final descent. This is where he has to be a little bit careful, can't afford a fall here. We had quite a few falls yesterday. Good skiing skills there, actually, just setting up with a little bit of a counter turn and holding the inside line. That inside line is slightly less slushy. And then using that energy as he came out of the corner to then bring that speed onto the first section of this climb. And this will be the final split at 12.1. And the final hill being tackled by the American. Bjorn Westervelt leads at the final split from the University of Vermont, majoring in mechanical engineering. Bjorn Westervelt is going to take the gold for the USA. And he did it the hard way. One of the fastest skiers in this competition, the fastest on the snow. As you can see, our little snowmen at the side of the course are cheering him on. He's almost caught an edge there. And Westervelt is going to take the gold for the USA. Skiing so fast, missed four targets, but even with those four penalty loops, it's gold for the United States. Bjorn Westervelt takes the gold. And still looks in great shape at the finish. So from Ukraine. Well, he's clear and he's away and he's just taking it easy over this last section. Hrushak is going to cross the line in silver. He knows it. So Dmitry Hrushak, the silver medal, 48 seconds back in the end. Well, he knew he was safe in the silver medal. And coming in for the bronze is Wojciech Janik. Wojciech Janik ahead of his teammate, Wojciech Filip. So the two Wojciechs from Poland in third and fourth. Did it the hard way. Four misses for Bjorn Westervelt. But the win, the gold medal, will go to USA. Ukraine with Dmitry Hrushak in silver medal and Wojciech Janik in bronze, just ahead of his teammate Wojciech Filip.
The mascots will be presented by Algis Shalna, the 1984 Olympic champion representing Lithuania.
Sarajevo 84, that was. I remember
in
that well.
In third place, representing Poland, Wojciech Janik.
Wojciech Janik from Poland in the bronze medal position. Given his Adirondack Mac.
In second place, representing Ukraine, Dmitry Hrushak.
Dmitry Hrushak from Ukraine in the silver medal position. It was a shame he had that one miss on the final visit to the range. It would have been an interesting final lap.
First
but
place,
I think that Bjorn Westervelt,
12.5 kilometer pursuit champion, representing the United States of America, Bjorn Westervelt.
Bjorn Westervelt in gold medal. Takes the gold for the United States.
The Lake Placid 2023 FISU World University Games winners.
So congratulations to the medalists. Congratulations to the winners. Bjorn Westervelt takes the gold. Dmitry Hrushak in silver and Wojciech Janik in bronze.